gonna let the sun shine in the day. I'm trying to make this darkness go away. I'll paint with colors and I'll sing until my lungs give out. I'm gonna let the sun shine in the day.
We all want to keep our kitchen sparkling clean and hygienic always. For this, we make a lot of efforts, like we do daily cleaning and we fix the schedule of weekly deep cleaning also. To make this process a little bit easy, today I am going to share with you all some super easy tips to keep your kitchen always clean, clutter-free and organized, and it would not take much time also. I would start from our most favorite thing, tea. Many people often ask how to keep the tea strainer always clean and dirt-free. The best practice for this is to clean it as soon as you strain the tea. Otherwise, if you leave it like this, the tea particles will get accumulated in it and become stubborn, and your tea strainer will start getting dirty. Therefore, to save your time and effort later, it would be better if you clean it thoroughly immediately. You can even clean the saucepan also. Trust me, you will still enjoy the hot tea. It just won't get cold while cleaning. Always try to make your space clutter-free as much as possible. Keep only frequently used items on countertop or as per your usage and ease. Like here, I am removing all these food containers of my Navratri fast and putting back in cupboard after using them. Also, the items which are not used frequently, like mixer, juicer, hand blender, etc., you can hide them in cupboards, but keep them in such a way that you can easily grab and use them. And rest of the time, you can enjoy working on your clean space. When you are keeping used tea cup or any used item in sink, just make sure that you give a few seconds to wash them. Even you can clean already kept bowls or plates also. Else, the items will keep piling up and then it would be a separate and time-taking task to do later. So better to clean as you put them. Because if you keep piling them up, it would attract more and more clutter. Whenever you keep something in microwave for reheating, whether it's a dry or a wet food, just spare a few seconds after taking that food out and make a habit of giving a quick wipe inside, as it's already moist and not sticky, therefore will be cleaned immediately. This way, you don't have to do much efforts to deep clean your microwave. Upon us, and I just wanna be where you are. I follow this rule, clean as you go. Similarly, spot cleaning is also like clean as you go. So whenever you spill something on countertop or on the floor, clean it immediately. Otherwise, it can leave the stains or can get more messy and would not be clean easily. Clean the spots and stains as you see them. Don't just ignore and wait for specific time to clean them. I just wanna be where you are. Keep the cleaning tools and supplies near to your eyes or reach to use them when needed without feeling lazy. So, when you see the dust anywhere, you can collect it immediately with the help of this tool without any delay and without being lazy. Because you can grab them easily as they are kept near to your reach. Best place to keep all these cleaning supplies and tools is this under the sink area. Cleaning, cutting, chopping are all the parts of our cooking process. And for that, we use the tools like knife, peeler, chopping board, mixing bowls, etc. But if we don't clean these tools and leave for a long time after using them, it would be difficult to make them odor and stain free. So always clean these tools after using them as soon as possible. This way we can use them for a long time. When we make any sabji or curry, it takes some time to cook. So instead of waiting and sitting idle till the time sabji is cooked, clean up the mixing bowls or any other item. And also clean all the mess like these spice boxes from the countertop, so that you can get a clean space for further cooking like making chapati or preparing rice. Otherwise, at the end, a lot of work will pile up and you may feel tired doing them. Slowly and gradually, I have incorporated a daily habit that whenever I wipe my kitchen countertop after cooking, I make sure that I wipe the chimney hood as well. It just needs a few seconds only. I realized that this way I wouldn't have to do weekly deep cleaning as often. Send me off with the words of a lullaby. Always make a designated place to keep delicate or heavy items after washing, like this rolling board or chakla, made of marble stone, so I can't keep it standing just anywhere, otherwise it may fall down and break. Therefore, to make it stand safely, I have designated this particular space with the support of this sink outline. But if you don't find and assign a proper place to keep them after washing, you may feel lazy washing them and end up using the dirty ones next time, which is not good for health. A very important step to maintain a tidy Indian kitchen is to clean all the mess right after you finish up making chapati, because you know so many tools are required for this and dust also spreads all over the countertop while making roti. Clean the gas stove or hob also, but be very careful of hot burners. I will take a leave now and see you all next week. If you like this video, please subscribe Abbott Diaries. Bye.